Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
Welcome to Rugby and back at a blister at Edinley Carnegie Stadium. We've got a varsity game going on behind us and I'm joined with the legend Wayne Wagatoris Godwin. How are you, lad?
Yeah, buzzing to be down here at Leeds Rhinos. Looking forward to the game, Jonesy.
If Simo didn't let you know, he was due his sixth child recently in the coming weeks. And this morning, Amy Simmons gave birth to his sixth child. Bless him, he's not going to be with us today at this game. But between us all, we've got a fair few children now. I've got four boys, Simo's got a tribe. And you and Kim have done a fair bit of breeding in recent years as well.
Yeah, I've got two boys, but let's talk about Simo's. Simo's name is give his new boy. Rocco Chev Thomas Simmons. How many names? What about Jonesy and Wagger?
Mate, Chev don't follow you all around country. I have to put up with you. And can you believe yesterday, the voice of the guy put on social media, I'm currently in labour with my wife expecting our sixth son. Guess the baby's name to win a full Rugby kit. Like the page, share and post and comment your name. Oh. Guess. Any opportunity for a bit of publicity, you've got it there, Simmons. Congratulations, pal. Now, today's game, we've got Leeds Rhinos versus Wakefield Wildcats. For me, it's a big game for Leeds, having to not bounce back, but perform again. It was a great performance against Catalan last week. Had a great performance. Sometimes, when you've had a loss like they did against Castleford the week before that, it's easier to come out buzzing. But to back up two good performances is really tough, particularly against a really good Wakefield side, potentially, Wagger.
Yeah, they're hitting a bit of form. Wakefield, they got a really, really good result. Against Salford, they've got some quality players. So I'm really, really looking forward to tonight's game. Some interesting competitions as well, Jonesy, between the forwards. I had a look at the team sheet and it looked a little bit. I'm interested to see how Kyle Wood goes against Parcell. I think that's an interesting contest at Hookers.
Hookers Club. Is it the fair bit, fair few forwards as well. Right then, Alex Simmons was here yesterday catching up with some of the lads, so check this out.
Mate, two close defeats, well, one close defeat to Saints and one absolute blowout against Cass. Apart from that, has it been a good start? Where do you think the team's at?
We're in a good place. I truly believe we're in a good place, you know. A couple of results here and there, you know, a bit skew with, really unlucky on first game, but then again, hats off to Saints, you know, they defended really well, just like us. It's difficult to say, but I feel we're in a good place and, you know, a win against Wakefield on cement that.
Mate, Wakefield, a tough outfit, coming to take a scalp. Every Boxing Day, we're all here after our Christmas dinner. Wakey beat Leeds every year. And
We drew with them, wouldn't you?
I'll give you that one. You had one draw. But this year, I think they're a serious outfit. They've improved. They've signed really well. Danny Kermond, we're back in this week. It's going to be a good game.
Well, you know, Wakefield are a great side. They've got strength and depth. You know, their outside backs are great and the forward, the truckers. So they'll keep tanking it up. But, you know, we usually back ourselves, you know, to see a game out in the 78th minute. But seeing their last two results, you know, last dying minutes, they're winning. So, you know, we know there's a game on for 80 minutes against Wakefield and we're looking forward to that challenge.
Mate, are you looking forward to this week? Because after Castleford, it was great to get a win last week. Hopefully going to back that up this week.
Yeah, we mentioned Castleford and, you know, we tried to mention it as little as possible. It wasn't a great day, you know, wearing a Leeds Rhino shirt. But we did what we needed to do last week, you know, to get back on the right track. We set out this year, you know, real good intentions, you know, be really successful this year. And they're the performances that we need to produce week in, week out.
Mate, you're like one of the old men now. I hate saying it to you because you're not overly old, but in this team, you're definitely one of the elder statesmen. It's testimonial year, which has been going really well. But how are these young boys coming through? Because I suppose that some of your results have been a bit character building for them.
We had a bit of that last year where the young lads got, you know, characterised.
Yeah.
Jonesy always talks I've known him for 10 years now, and he talks every year about he likes the young ones coming through. And I never really, you know, got to grasp what he's been talking about until now.
Now you're getting old.
Now I look at the old, and there's a lot of young ones coming through. But it does talk some sense sometimes, Jonesy, and it really has come true that the future is the young kids, and you know what they can bring and their enthusiasm, what they can bring every week. And I think we've got a great bunch of them.
Brett Ferris, you're back in the fold this week. It must have been a really frustrating time watching the team through a few ups and a few downs, especially the cash result as you're a cast lad. Are you excited to be stepping back out here onto Headingley Carnegie Stadium?
Yeah, I am, yeah. It's been very frustrating. It's been quite a while now. It's been nearly four or five months since I've been actually on the field running about and backing the boys, having a bit of a laugh and a bit of banter. So, yeah, it's been certainly a tough time, but it was like you say, the cast result was obviously a bit of a spur towards trying to obviously get out there and help the boys. It's been a difficult period there where we had, and obviously disappointing to watch. So, yeah, it's great to be back out here and stepping back on the Halo turf.
Mate, you look massive. You put some size on.
Yeah, I've put quite a bit on, yeah. Hopefully good weight.
Nah,
I'm quite a big lad anyway. And, to be fair, I've missed out on a lot of weights over the years, so it's been a real good period now to get some real size and bulk into me and some strength, obviously. So, yeah, I've put a bit of weight on now and hopefully carry it all right this week.
Obviously, I'm going to ask you, as one of the oldest statesmen in the club, some of these young lads you're training with day in, day out, who's really, really impressed you from a talent point of view?
Ashton, I think he stood up very well. He's a strong kid, trains very hard, he's worked hard to get his spot, obviously, with Zach departing and getting a number one shirt as well, obviously, as a Leeds boy, is massive. So, yeah, he's certainly got some talent there, and once he gets some game sense and awareness and obviously experience there, obviously at the back, he's a young kid still, so talk-wise and things like that will come with time and experience and playing, so he's certainly impressed early season.
Stevie Lord, Leeds Rhinos, Vac Rubber, nickname Lordy.
Liam Sutcliffe, number 14, Leeds Rhinos, utility man, and nickname Suncliffe.
Suncliffe!
He left rugby union to go back to Saints.
Sam Burgess.
Massive Saints front roller. Number four, is he? Massive.
Yeah, Walmsley?
Yeah, that's it. Chief Executive Leeds Rhinos.
Got over it.
Old school, number six for Leeds. There's a suite up there named after
Lewis Jones?
Yes. I can't even read that. Stand up for Cass, is he? Killing it at the minute.
Really?
Yeah. Killing it for Wigan at the minute. Stand up.
George Owen.
I think he's cutting air with Baldy right at the minute.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
Josh Walt?
Yeah. And he's a winger for us, and he got dropped for the Cass game for Ash Hamblin.
They're not first one, so used to coach here, Aussie legend, passed away.
Graham Murray?
Yeah. Just come back here, used to play. Coaching now.
Kylie Luan?
Nah, used to Hornton.
Adrian Morley?
Yeah. Coach.
What?
As coach?
Yeah. Oh, what?
As coach?
Our coach?
Yeah.
Brian Mack. What are you talking about, boss?
Little, no sound, Frog don't like it, won't.
Who don't like him?
Frog.
Oh, Rob Burrow.
Scott.
He doesn't like
Scott's
him.
Scott's horrified tries at Wembley in...
Tonbridge School?
Nah, recording for Leeds.
Otherwise, why is Maid gone? Maid's gone. Maid's gone.
99.
Who did he beat? Elvie Hanley?
Yeah. No. Pass that.
Pass.
You see another 10. Legend.
Here?
Yeah.
Jimmy Peacock?
Yeah.
I had Leo in my head.
I thought we were going to get in there.
Good to hear from boys there. Join us in part two, where we're going to be going down with Jordan Baldwinson and Josh Walters down to Barber Bees. Now, our day, Wagger, we didn't have lads cutting each other's hair.
No.
You've always had a sharp haircut, but it just didn't happen, did it?
No, it didn't happen. I had a text, actually, off Ashley Gibson wanting to cut my hair last week, so I think I'm going to get involved. So if anyone wants to cut it, give us a shout.
It's a great piece. Join us in part two.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry. Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
Welcome back to part two here at BM. We've left Headley for the time being and come into local community because Jones has been a phenomenon with behind the scenes at Leeds. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, it's a crazy one, and it's different from back in my day when I was growing up. Lads used to go to barbers to get their hair cut, and I used to enjoy it, mate. It's been a long time coming. But these boys here have started cutting hair, and Baldy and Josh Waltz over here have even opened their own barbers at Kirksall Training Ground.
And what was the drive? Obviously, you've got kid and play haircut going on. What was the passion behind your barbering, mate?
It's always a good place to go, and you always look forward to, like James said, going down to the barbers and seeing your mates there. And I thought it'd be a good environment to be in. And I've tried dabbled, you know, a few things outside of rugby, but this was the thing that I wanted to do.
And you've got a bit of a cult following now. You've both got your names, your trade names. You know, tell us what they are.
Obviously, I'm Barber Baldy, not because I make you all bald, because that's my name. And we've got Barber Dubs over here.
Barber Dubs.
Yeah, so, but yeah, it's going well, we're really enjoying it. We've got a little whiteboard now down in changing rooms for boys down at Leeds. So when boys need an haircut or they need a game day fade, just come and ask boys and we just sort them out, don't we, really? So it's going well.
Jonesy, they've having some training over at Huddersfield at university, but I thought they need some on-the-job training. And we've got a very close friend of the show, Barber B, has been big in the game for 25 years. And you may remember back in 1999 when he cut Leroy Rivette's hair as he went on to win the Cup and score four tries at Wembley. We're going to go down to Piranha in Leeds, take the boys and meet Barber B. Does it feel like 25 years, mate? Looking back, you look like a young Peter Andre on that picture.
Nah, it feels like yesterday. 25 years has flown by. This year we're launching the Piranha Barbering Academy. We're running apprenticeship programs, we're doing one day cutting courses. So to get involved with the Leeds Rhinos and the Rugby Boys for their introduction into the barbering world is a great honor and a pleasure. And I'm looking forward to kind of moving forward with a long-term plan for the players and myself to run the academy for another 25 years.
Could you take my beard on?
We can take your beard on, definitely. You did ask me a minute ago, can I do beards?
Oh!
Precious, precious, precious.
Right, I'm going to get in one chair, Jones is getting another chair, and Barber's going to let the boys loose on my hair and his beard.
Right, we've got Alex Simmons in his chair, and we've got Barber B just about to start his work, do his stuff, do his artistry, and then Baldy Bouncer is going to do the other half of Alex Simmons' hair, and that's where it's going to get really exciting. You've just prepped your clippers there.
Right, so once you've cleaned your clippers and you've prepped, you'll adjust your taper arm to zero, okay?
Yep.
You'll glide the clippers very lightly. You'll have the clippers up on the toes, okay? Very technical term. Have your clippers up on the toes. And you'll just very lightly just glide over the skin. You're not putting no pressure on. It's very soft, it's very smooth, all in one motion, okay?
What's the biggest mistake that new barbers often make?
The lack of training, I think. They kind of rush into things. If they haven't got the correct training, then you're likely to run into serious problems. I think running before you can walk, kind of being overconfident can be a big mistake. You've just got to take your time. If in doubt, leave it on. Right. That's my motto.
Like that.
If in doubt, leave it on. Cool. Always like leave that. It longer than shorter. You can always go back. If you take it too short, your client's not going to be happy.
Right, here's a moment of truth here, Barber. You're going to give the clippers over to Baldy and let him loose on the other side of Alex's head. I think Simo might on his own side of his melon this week. And, right, what's the first thing he's got to start considering?
Right, okay. Clippers, how the set, tape around forward to zero, pull it back for half. Mm-hmm. Put a line in, just gonna nice and steady, nice and smooth, take all his hair off. Exactly. We're gonna keep his beard. Once you've taken off the short back and sides, we'll then put it onto a half and just fade him up nice and slow, steady away. So, grid half.
Yeah, half. And then just blend that in. That
and just blend it in. And then you pull back your arm half the length that you've just done and travel half the distance that you've just gone. Half a half.
Like it.
Okay.
Like it.
Half a half. Right, and then half the distance again.
Yeah.
And travel half the distance again. That's half a half a half.
Right,
very technical stuff. Please, you won't forget.
Half a half a half.
Which is what, Baldy?
Which is half a half a half, isn't it?
And that's as technical as it gets. What I've learned about teaching this is that you've got to keep it very simple.
Yeah.
There's no point in overcomplicating something that's not complicated.
Yeah, okay.
And that's the kind of principle behind my training, okay?
Yeah, all right,
okay. So half, half a half, half a half a half. That's it. Then you travel half the distance again, and then shorten the length and half the distance again. That's it.
Jones's beard is like an institution in rugby league. It's official. I think it's the first beard to start the trend of all the beards, according to Jonesy. He went nervous tackling on the legend's beard.
Well, he doesn't actually know what he wants with it. I think he needs a bit of a TLC.
What would you do? If you could choose to do anything, what would you do?
Well, you'd have to get some products in it, wouldn't you? And you'd maybe trim it down a bit. Not too much, because you don't want to, but get rid of it. Scraggly ends and make it look a bit neater.
But what are you thinking, mate?
Well, it's the beard of legends, isn't it? If you cut, if you cut his beard off, it's like cutting off his hair, isn't it? You're going to lose his strength. So basically, all it really needs is, Samson, that's what we're looking for, the god of. It's just going to be a scissor trim, very light. You'll kind of just give it a good comb out. We'll literally chisel his cheekbones high up here, and you'll comb it into the shape, follow the shape of his jawline, pull it all down, and then literally just catch the whiskers. It doesn't want to be too neat, it just wants to be lightly trimmed so that it's got a nicer shape to it. It's just almost like having an afro on your chin.
Barbie, we've done half his head here, you've got left for Jonesy. He's gonna down to a zero, just keep it on
there. Down to
a
zero, peel it off.
Yeah.
Enhance his beard even
Need some product on that as well, doesn't it? It's a bit dry, his old scalp there. Can you do it for an old dry scalp like that?
It's not really that bad. It's just him having a go. You'll never find me dissing the client's head, no matter what happens, always in front of me. It's beautiful.
Beautiful.
All natural. Yeah,
it is a funny shape though, isn't it? Took a few whacks as that.
No comment.
What's that, mate?
Rob Burrell says, my head needs putting in a museum when I'm done with it, mate. So he reckons I should donate it to science, the big coffee bin.
You want to keep your beard square? Okay. Yeah, just a little bit. Okay, I'm just going to put. Okay, so if you see with the lighter colour, if you look in the mirror, you can see, you'll be able to see the bottom of his beard, you'll be able to create the shape of you. So if you roll your head back a little bit for me. So we're just again across the bottom, literally just nice and light. Take off minimum, okay? If in doubt, leave it on. You can't ever go wrong, okay? Always leave it rather too long than too short. No, because we've combed it all forward. if you just give it a little sniff, there you go. His hair looks like the top of your head.
So Jonesy's been done, I've been done. Let's see the finished product all together and see what Barber makes of the Baldy Bouncer and Barber Dubs. Right, big thanks to Barber B and the team at Parama for looking after us today.
Absolutely.
Jonesy, you asked him if he could do beards, are you happy with your beard?
Mate, he's done a great job. They're coming in here judging everybody and he's been fantastic. Smells good as well, Simo.
Baldy Watts, have you learned something today?
Yeah, learned, you know, more than I have in the past month, just in, you know, a couple of hours here, so thanks very much, Barber B.
Baldy, one thing you can take away from today, what would it be?
Probably that they make sure that I'm charging people now. No more free haircuts, that's enough now, no more free haircuts. But no, I really appreciate it, Barber, we really appreciate it. We've learned a lot this just with this 1 hour that we've been here, so I'm really grateful, thank you.
Right, it's time to go back to Headingley for part three of the show and see how Leeds are getting on against Wakefield.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry. Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
Great beer trim there from Barber B. I reckon it's probably one of the best I've ever had. Right, we're at half time here. These Rhinos versus Wakefield Wildcats. It's been a decent game so far. Some great tries from Callum Watkins times two, Anthony Mullally, and next standing lad, Tom Johnson, who we will be joining in part four, speaking at the World's Way Charity Do. Wago, what do you reckon of that first half?
Yeah, it's been a tough game, tough conditions, but Leeds have played it a lot better. Cal Watkins looking very dangerous with the ball early.
Sharp, isn't
he? My twin brother, Parcells, killing it around the ruck. they've been trying to get it to Brett a little bit, but I think Aron has been their danger man for Wakefield. Yep. Giving the ball early is looking really strong.
I must say, Williams has put some great kicks in for Wakefield. His structure of the Wakefield look really good. It's been interesting, Wagger, how the table looks a bit topsy-turvy at the minute. St Helens and Warrington near the bottom. How do you make of it all?
It's tough. Like you say, I watched the game, Liam Warrington, and Liam really up there. And no easy game. Like Mickey Arm said, no easy game. And you've got to be up there every week to compete.
I think throughout the course of the season, Wagger, a team is only as good as its teammates, how much synergy, how much cohesion they've got. I'm sure St Helens and Warrington will pull it all together. Right now, we're going back to Barber B's for Jordan Baldinson and Josh Walters doing the Leeds Rhinos teammates.
Jordan Baldinson, nicknamed Baldy, squad number 24, Leeds Rhinos, prop forward.
Josh Walters, squad number 21, position loose forward, back row, nickname Waltz.
Oh, not sure. From my experience so far, Singo loves a good thrombey on field, doesn't he? Absolutely. He hammered me last week. I can't say it because he won't be able to put it out on telly, but let's just say I walked off field thinking, he looked at me and he gave me the death stare and I thought, he's going to whip me, but God, he loves to blow up on the field.
Yeah, on the field it'd be someone competitive like that, Singer. Yeah. So the real, really competitive people, so maybe Jonesy again. Can, or Magsy will tell you. Magsy's not afraid to tell you, is he? But yeah. Oh, we haven't really got many sulkers.
No.
You like to sulk a bit, don't you, off the pitch? But
sometimes.
Maybe. But apart from that, I don't really know. I'm gonna say Joel Mooney. He's ridiculous.
Yeah,
Mooney's ridiculous. He can do anything, and he's a bit like He's not. Yeah. He's really laid back, isn't he?
Yeah, he's really laid back. He's the cool guy that everyone wants to, you know, everyone wants to be. He's just the cool guy. He's got the move. He's got the skills.
You seen that last weekend? He played half back and he's a centre and he killed it. So
he plays half when he's ever done half.
That says it all, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Brett Ferris.
Yeah, Ferris. Oh my gosh.
He's come after you a couple of times, hasn't he? And you,
you know what?
You didn't want to come training, did you?
I didn't. I nearly handed him in P45. He's had a few goals at me, Fez. Nothing bad, but just like the odd.
He's got a good, like a poker face in it. Yeah. Like you can't tell if he's being serious or not.
And then just
when you think he's being serious, he's joking.
He's joking, yeah. But no, I won't start on Ferris. So I definitely wouldn't. Do you know what? Sam Allis once matched with his sister on Tinder.
Yes, Sam Allis matched with his sister on Tinder.
He didn't mean to do it. They were swiping, swipe.
He just does that thing where he didn't look and just goes like
his
that.
His sister popped up on Tinder and he swiped his sister, so he's got to go down as that one for that.
I think he's got a bit of a thing
for that. I think I'm sure he kissed his cousin at a wedding once, didn't he? And didn't know it was his cousin. So, you know, I'm sorry, Sam, but it needs to be said. Lily on it.
Jordan Lily all day. Lily.
Everywhere he goes, they just love him. I think it's because he looks like he's 12 and all 12-year-olds think it's the same age as him.
He looks like that little kid off Up, doesn't he? That's what he looks like.
He's like,
so all the little kids think he's from Up, and then all the parents are, oh, that's the Leeds Rhinos player. So
yeah, they can't believe it. Kind of combines like 12-year-old little boy over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely Jordan Lily.
Fez, it's been a long time coming. You're looking big and strong, pal. Did you enjoy it?
Definitely looking big. I loved it. Yeah, really good to get back out with the boys and obviously a decent win. Got a bit more game time than expected there. I think I was only meant to do 15 minutes. And
yeah, he always says that.
The famous last words. So yeah, pleasing to get some decent game time on the belt and obviously come out with a win then.
Good to see so many lads going out there and playing well. You know, we've just been going to corporate stuff, going out long bar and that, and talking about who potentially could have been man at match. And there's a fair few names popping up. It's really encouraging to see this time of year, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, mate. Yeah, obviously after the disappointing defeat at Cass, we've certainly turned it around and look a more well-balanced side. I think clearly some younger boys have stepped up and the older senior boys have started to lead now from the front, and that's very important. And we all seem to be just buying into what we're doing and what we're achieving there, and it's great to see.
Woody, how are you, mate, after that tough result for you boys to handle?
Yeah, we're a bit battered and bruised and a bit disappointed in that game. We just didn't turn up, to be honest, and Leeds just put on a decent show, and the very quick round the ruck and the exposures round the dummy half area.
How are you finding these kind of conditions to play in from your Australian days?
Yeah, it's good. The game day doesn't worry me if it's a bit cold. It's been really good all week, sunshine. So, but yeah, I'm sort of looking forward to it. I can't wait for when summertime comes and it sort of dries up a bit. But yeah, I'll just take each week as it comes.
Been a fellow hooker myself, former Super League player. I was really impressed tonight. I thought you killed it round the ruck. Run loads, and I thought you were outstanding, mate, so well done.
No, thank you. I just sort of, yeah, we're sort of fitting in, we're getting a bit of combinations now, so I just sort of really looking forward to sort of progressing each week and seeing how far we can go.
Awesome, pleasure to meet you.
No worries, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're always talking about your diet, mate, particularly with your recovery now. So, joking aside, a lot of lads like to go home, have a bit of pizza, have a little bit of meat. What will you do when you get home tonight?
Well, it's Paddy's Day, so I'll probably have a Guinness, but half Irish in there. But I'll be a veggie pizza. I'll probably have, yeah.
Is that one of your favourites?
That's one of my favourite cheat meals, yeah.
If I was going to be a vegetarian, I'd start with the samosas. Do you like samosas?
Veggie samosas, yeah, I love them, mate.
Oh, mate, unbelievable. And actually, I will say, I've read a few articles that say a pint of Guinness or one pint of beer is not a bad recovery tool, is that right?
Yeah, especially Guinness, full of iron in it, real dense.
Absolutely. Well, we're back here in a few weeks against Wigan, Huddersfield Giants next week, but well done, Paul.
Cheers,
great
pal.
To see you out there.
Cheers, buddy. Let's go to work! Let's go to work!
UK Red Fire and Security Fan Cam, joined by two lovely Leeds Rhinos ladies. What do you reckon to the game, ladies?
Brilliant. Absolutely fantastic.
How many beers you had tonight?
Loads.
I can tell. Good work. Thank you for joining us. I need some Wakey fans. Any Wakey fans? Can't seem to find any Wakefield fans, so I'm joined again by some more Leeds Rhinos. How do you think tonight's game went?
Yeah, I think they're good, but I think they still need to improve.
Still need improvement. Yeah. Who impressed you tonight out of the boys?
Danny Maguire tonight. Best player, Danny Maguire, isn't he?
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Right, I need some Wakey fans, don't I? Very, very happy. Very, very happy, man. Another Leeds Rhinos fan. Have you been getting your beard chopped at the same place as Jonesy?
No, mine's better than Jonesy's.
Yours better than Jonesy's.
Well distinguished. Can't beat him though, mate, can you?
No, what do you reckon to tonight's game then?
It was steady away. Enjoyed it.
Who impressed you out of the lads tonight?
Most of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. This week, last week, not a man of the match, team of the match.
I need a Wakey fan. Any Wakey fans? Come on. Louder, boys. Dance as well. Holy. In five voices, the young Leeds Rhinos tonight. Well done, boys. Wakey fans. Oh, we've got some. They're still here. I'm joined finally by some Wakefield fans, should I say. Everyone else has left.
So what do you reckon, Paul, mate?
Disappointed?
Very disappointing.
What do you reckon Chris Chester and the crew were saying in the changing rooms? What went wrong?
Just telling a few home truths, poor defence, poor in attack, just generally poor tonight.
I'm joined by a Scotsman. Who were you supporting tonight?
Leeds Rhinos tonight.
Who impressed you out of the boys?
Rob Burrows when he came on, he ran the show when he came back on. And
they were outstanding. Parcell were outstanding again.
Absolutely, and Ryan Hall just finished off the tries, you know.
For work.
Yeah, I don't have a clue at any of the Wakefield players.
You don't know anyone?
Build the wall!
It's
going to be great.
Oh, Paddy.
It's going to be great.
No,
yes, the boys!
Build the wall!
They're not bothered about rugby, they just want to build a wall! So build that wall!
That's not the Scottish referendum we're on about, that's more about. That's more about the Americans or Mexicans.
Sweet chariots! Coming for you!
Sweet champion chariot, have your
swing!
I don't know what's going on, but they don't support anyone. But they're just singing. They're just singing.
To carry me home. Come on,
St. Paddy! Straight to the boys!
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry. Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
Welcome back to part four of Rugby AM. The game's over. Leeds have got a victory, quite a convincing one in the end. To be fair, Wakefield played pretty well, didn't they? I thought Wakefield had some really good spells. Particularly technically, I thought they kicked really well, looked really well structured. We just had a bit too much from them tonight.
Yeah, Tom Johnson, when he got the ball, looked very dangerous. Like I touched on before, Arona looked strong. They've got some quality players, Wakefield.
Right, I'm glad you mentioned Tom Johnson, because he came along with people like Gareth Carvel, Jamie Peacock, John Lilly. Ex-Stanley players like myself who've come through the amateur clubs and represented, played professional rugby, and a famous artist, a really well-known professional artist, has done a painting of all the ex-professional Stanley rugby league players, or current professionals as well. All the lads that came through the Stanley club and became professional players were all in this picture, and it was for the Will's Way charity. Now, Will is a young kid, played at Stanley. Unfortunately, he was suffering with a brain tumour back end of last year, but he courageously fought through his treatment. He's in good spirits at the minute, and we had Will's Way charity to raise some money for him. But check this out, catch up with some of the old Stanley players and the guys who are doing some great stuff for Rugby League.
I'm joined by Jamie Peacock here at the amazing charity event raising money for Will's Way. Jamie, how do you feel knowing that you're raising money and being part of something incredible tonight, this charity event?
Yeah, I just think, looking around, there's 400 people here, and it speaks volumes about Rugby League as a community, and also this part of Leeds as a community, that people can rally around, someone and turn out the time and be generous tonight.
So as part of the event, there's a painting just behind us that has been painted and you're in it. What do you think of the painting?
I think it's outstanding. I think to be good at art and to have that ability, it's a great ability to have. And to give up his time to do this for such a magnificent cause, and it involves rugby league as well, it's fantastic.
Do you think it's a good reflection? Does it look like you on the painting?
Well, I don't know why I've got my hands on my head. I must have seen that goal go over against for Salford, that's why.
Why do you think it's so important to support the Stanningley boys? Because obviously Will's been at Stanningley. Why do you think it's so important being a Stanningley boy yourself?
Well, I just think when I was younger growing up, rugby gave me a pathway into what I'm doing here today. And I think you should always pay respect to your roots. And if it wasn't the Stanley Rugby Club, I wouldn't be stood here today. And there's thousands of other boys who could say the same things. Kept me out of trouble and keeps other boys out of trouble too.
That's amazing. Well, won't keep you any longer because I know you've got your speech. So good luck with that. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. No
worries. Thank you.
Roxy's run off to go get Bob back. We're going to have a chat about the painting real soon. But I've just found the best two looking guys, rugby players ever, to come out of Stanningley. We've got Tom Johnson and Tom Dizzinetti. Ashley Gibson, aka boys, just where do you get your hair cut, you two? Have you got the same spot or what?
Mate, you won't believe me if I tell you, we've been doing a barber's course at rugby.
Wow.
Oh, it's a college in Huddersfield, so I got it cut on Thursday. It was Jamie Ellis did the sides,
right,
and then Danny Addy did the top the other day. The week before, Adam Miller did it.
Are you as good looking on here as you are in real life, Gibbo?
I think I've got a scrum at on there, you know, to be honest. I'm just trying to work out there. It's covering me this hairdo up in it, so I'm not. No, but it's for a great cause, so yeah, it's amazing for it, you know, yeah.
I think it's outstanding. It's a shame I haven't got a beard, but I think I'm only about 8 years old in this photograph, so I'll let him off. But it's a great cause, isn't it, Gibbo? I think it's fantastic. All professionals, ex-Stanningley players have come back to support young Will.
Yeah, definitely. Just what JP said, just about all the rugby community, like, say, from everyone's from Bramley, Stanningley, just all come together. Yeah, it's pretty special, and yeah.
I'm joined by Bob Barker, Will's uncle, and the amazing artist behind the painting that's going to be auctioned off this evening. Tell us, Bob, a bit about why did you paint what you've painted?
Well, obviously I painted it because of Will, and because of what Will's been going through and the way that he's been doing it, and the charity that he's decided that he wants to give this money to other people who are maybe not quite as fortunate as what he is, which I think is quite absolutely amazing character on Will's behalf.
Yeah.
I paint for a living and I earn my living out of painting pictures, so the thing that I can do to help Will and help the charity for Will is to do what I think best, is paint the picture.
That's incredible.
And it's the inspiration from Will growing up as a rugby player and playing rugby, and obviously the guys that are here tonight who feature in the picture, you know, they obviously started off in Stanningley, which I think is a massive inspiration behind this whole event. So that's where the picture came from, where the painting came from.
So in terms of the painting, what made you do that certain design? You know, why in that setting?
Well, it sort of features, it's almost what I'm known for doing. You get, as an artist, you get to a certain level and people know that you paint certain things or in a certain style.
Yeah.
And that is like in the style of Bob Barker, per se. And I did a picture quite a while ago, and it was called The Passion, and it was for that other sport that's maybe not quite as popular as rugby league, which is football. And it was probably one of the best sellers. They put an edition of something like 195 out, did my publishing company, and it sold in days.
Wow.
And I based this on a very, very similar theme. It's quite, with all the shadows coming off of the guys and things, I knew it was a winner before I even started painting it.
That's brilliant. So in terms of tonight, you're auctioning off your painting. How can people who are watching this get involved with sort of sending money to the charity or even buying a, you know, replica of your painting?
Well, my publishers are Washington Green Fine Art. They are one of the biggest publishers in Europe, and they own a franchise of galleries all across, nationwide across the country, called Castle Galleries, and they will be selling all the edition. Not only the special editions that are getting signed by all the players tonight, but they're going to sell the normal edition, throughout the galleries. So any Castle Gallery any Washington Green Fine Art website, you can find information about this. As far as the original is concerned, that's going to be an online auction, and that might be a few weeks before they actually get round to doing that, but that's going to be done through my publishing company, and it's all going to be sealed bids, and I think we're just hoping to get as much as we possibly can for it. That's the idea.
Bob, it's amazing what you've done. Thank you so much.
You're very
and
welcome.
Good luck with the auction.
Yes, let's hope it goes well.
I'm joined by Ty Barker, Will Barker's dad. What do you think of the turnout tonight?
I'm just overwhelmed, to be fair, really. Obviously, I knew it was always going to be a great occasion, but when you see so many people in such a large room and it's actually full, I just can't believe that so many people have turned up for us.
And they're all here for your son and the charity that he's created. Does that make you feel really proud as a father?
It does, yeah, but obviously it shows as well with rugby community how people pull together, don't they, as
yeah.
well? All they need is a little whisper of something happening and they'll just dig so deep for you.
Yeah, so we've been selling lots of charity things tonight for the charity, we've been auctioning things off. How does that make you feel knowing that people have come for such a great cause and they're helping this charity that you've created?
Well, like I say, I know that the rugby family will do anything for you and they'll just dig deep and they'd climb a mountain for you if they could do.
So for people out there that are watching, that have been in a similar situation possibly to Will, you know, you've created such an amazing event tonight. That kind of gives them a glimmer of hope. So what kind of advice would you give to people out there that have been in the same predicament that you've been in as a family?
Well, just, I think, like how Will's been, is just like, never give up. Obviously, we've had some bad news over the last year or so, last 6 months. He's just lifted his head up high, he's carried on, he's lived his normal life really. And it just shows that you can't be weak really, you've got to be strong with things. And
so Will was in the foundation video, featured in it, and he's also in the painting. What do you think about the painting?
Well, the painting's amazing. Obviously, it's one of the things that my uncle said straight away when obviously we knew what bad times we were going through, that he just wanted to help us along with something, and obviously that's the best thing he could do. And although we've got the 12 Super League players, it just said that William's got to be in the middle of it and he's got to be centre of the point, because that's what it's all about. It's all about William and trying to raise money for a great charity, hopefully.
I'm joined by Gareth Carvel. Gareth, how are you feeling tonight? Is it a good event? Are you enjoying yourself?
Yeah, very good. Turned up late as usual, but that's the fashion apparently. But yeah, really good. Jamie's got everyone excited. Shame about the buffet. I was looking forward to, you know, a bit more of a scram, but what can you do? But no, it's a brilliant event. We've got a lot of fundraising to be done throughout the night, and yeah, really looking forward to it.
So why do you think events like this are so important?
I think a lot of people talk about rugby league like the rugby league family, and it tends to be wherever there's a situation that's a bit dire or somebody's struggling along, everyone pulls together, and it's exactly what's happened here. You know, Will's Way is a fantastic charity. It's just so unfortunate, but everyone in rugby league just gets together and puts events like this on. So it's sort of the way of rugby league, which you know, it makes me proud to be playing. Well, was playing. Ex-player.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.